the Department of Conservation manages almost one-third of New Zealand's land area. Hundreds of huts, thousands of kilometres of tracks, threatened species, ecosystems, concessions, and more. In order to manage all of this, we need to understand what land we manage, what is happening there, and what is happening nearby. All of this information, which informs our decision making and guides our day-to-day work, is spatial information, and the way we collect, store, and analyse it is with a GIS, or Geographic Information System. Spatial information has two components: a geographic location, that is, a definite place that can be identified using coordinates, and the information or metadata attached to this place. For example, we can see that there is a hut located at this particular set of coordinates. By looking at the attached metadata, we can see that this is Angela's hut, that it is a serviced hut, and all of the other information we need to know about this place. Spatial information can come directly from GPS devices, such as a ranger in the field marking the location of a weed species, from real-time tracking devices, such as GPS collars, or even from automatic data loggers, such as remote weather stations. Maps, aerial photos, and even satellite imaging data can be digitised and brought into the GIS. Finally, information can be created directly on a computer using specialised GIS software applications. Once data has been created, it is processed and then stored in DOCS database. From the database, this information can be accessed from anywhere that is linked into the network. By using a central GIS database and a standardised naming convention, the data is easier to locate and also can be used by a wider audience. For example, trappers record catch information every time they clear their stoat traps. This is added to a shapefile which records the location of each trap. A GIS analyst can then assess the effectiveness of each trap line and overlay Kiwi territories to check there are no gaps in our coverage. Rangers carrying out structure inspections enter information into data loggers. These are synced with the GIS database to create complete and up-to-date inventories of all our visitor assets. This can then be used to create accurate maps and information for visitors and to help us better manage our visitor infrastructure. Concession staff can use GIS to help assess permissions, such as those for marine mammal viewing. GIS can be used to identify the extent of marine protected areas and to identify sensitive areas that operators need to be aware of. We could also use GIS to calculate the number of operators in an area, or even to report back to externals like Treasury on the number of commercial concessions nationwide. Spatial information is relevant to all aspects of work at DOC, and GIS helps us to share this information and to work more effectively and collaboratively.